I mean, now really, what was so hard about that? Salt life.
The real salt life. That's what was wrong with it.
What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the shop. Today, we have an 06 Dakota Dodge. And in celebration for No Mopar No Car September, just made it up, we're going to remove the transmission and we're going to do a clutch job on this. Something that I don't do too often, but it's always fun to do. And I figured today I would take you guys along with me and maybe we both can learn something. If you have any comments, put them down in the comments to help me, although it's not really going to help me because this video isn't going to be out yet, but I digress. Let's go ahead and let's get started. Okay, we got her jacked up. We're doing pretty good so far. Oh, wow. Have I worked on this? I think I have worked on this before. Yeah, that's fine. Okay. So, order of operation. As you can see, I have our screw jack supporting the transmission. What we got to do is we're going to take off this drive shaft. Luckily enough, old Dodge made it easy for us. Just crack those and then we're going to let that go ahead and hang down and then start working on this cross member. There's four bolts up there. I think I'm going to take that apart. And then right here, sorry about the light, but then remove those two bolts and those two bolts. And in theory, our cross member should come down. Then we could start working up here on our transmission and getting that out. But yeah, she's got the good old muffler delete, doesn't she? Zip ties approved. Not really. No, I'm gonna see if actually they want to do something with that. I forgot the GoPro, so I have to film with my phone. I promise you I will never do that ever again. I'm sorry. So loosen up that one, removed the two on the other side. Now, oh my gosh, the Milwaukee is just a beast, isn't she? That's a 3/8 gun, too. Okay, so one more. Hopefully it won't fall, but I'm out of the way. I really didn't think it would fall. They usually don't. Usually have to go get Mr. Hammer and do hammer time. I think this won't be too bad. Now the thing here is you want to hit somewhere more solid. You don't want to obviously hit on the ends of the yokes there or there. But I like to usually go somewhere like right here. You also don't want to obviously mess up those holes. So we'll just give her a little crack. And she's being a bitch. Again, don't hit there. Okay, I'm gonna have to set you down. Okay, so basically, yeah, just a little bit of a pounding got her off of there. She usually will kind of get stuck up around that. So we're gonna clean all that off before we go back with it. But that is step one. Now let's move on to removing our cross member. Okay, let's start where you can't see. Give me that. Thank you. Okay. Okay, so now I've got this one. Oh, that one, I feel like this one I could just get out. So we're going to start removing these four bolts. And the weight of the transmission is going to actually sit on this still, which it doesn't really matter because we have the screw jack on it. But this is just the way I usually like to do it. So I will remove, wait patiently, I will remove these four screws. We have two more back up there. You can kind of see it right there. I don't feel like moving my light, I'm sorry. One right there and then one right there. So we're going to do that next, and then I got to find out what size these are here. Oh, 17. 17 on one side, 18 on, no, 19 on the other. All right, so we'll come back whenever I have that disconnected, and we're gonna go ahead and take those off. Okay, always keep your bolts together and nice and neat. Man, they really did it with the blue Loctite on that, didn't they? So, all right, we have everything disconnected, and as I turn our screw jack, you can see the transmission can't do too much. You can see it kind of lifts off. That means we're disconnected. So, like I said, 17 on this side, it looks like, and a 19 on that side. I don't think I'm going to be able to do this whilst holding the camera because I'm going to have to put a 17 wrench on that side and come at it with my half-inch gun on this side. I've already made sure in all of these, the whole bolts, they do spin. So sometimes they'll kind of get caught up in here and get all corroded, especially where we live. But they're turning, so I think it'll be pretty easy. But yeah, that's just the next step. Remove those, remove those. Make sure your transmission is supported. Onward and upward. Okay, I've got another screw jack to support this, just to kind of take the pressure off of it. And I've already removed one bolt from each side. Now with that pressure up, it's real easy to remove this other one. Plus, the cross member won't come falling down on you. So, everything's a hammer, even your palm will work. So, in theory, oh, okay, yeah, no, they never just fall right out, so that's fine. They only fall out when you're standing under them, so beware of that. I wonder if I can do this with one hand while holding the camera. Nope, that's dangerous. All right, I'm gonna bang that out of there, and actually, I wonder if I can get you over here. Maybe. Let's get a pry bar. Might not be pry bar time. Might be hammer. Get a real one. Give me a lever long enough and I can move the world. Now what I said was, give me a lever long enough and I can move the world. That was what I said. This thing's, you don't want them falling down now, isn't it? Giving away the trade secrets. I mean, now really, what was so hard about that? Salt life. The real salt life. That's what was wrong with it. Okay. So now, if we lower this, you will see, well, it's kind of hard to tell, but it's coming down. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do is I'm gonna go ahead and completely remove the transmission. And there's gonna be bolts all going all around. This is called the bell housing. And basically what you do is, like I just did, you lower it and then you'll be able to get better access up there. I know you can't really see right now. Very, very hard to see. But underneath that O2 wire, I can see one. Then there's gonna be another one up there. And then kind of the same on the other side. So let's go ahead. I'm gonna do that off camera, obviously. And we'll see you in a couple hours. All right, so I probably should have mentioned the old gear shifter knob thing. So now I'm pretty sure you just put a wrench on this portion and it should come right off. I got the old adjustable wrench. Probably not using it the right way, but whatever. There we go. See, that's all you need. And just give her a spin. We'll keep spinning. See, that's threaded on there. And voila. So now, I think this boot all comes out. But I think it might just actually go ahead and slide down. So, yeah. I think you just kind of fish it through there. If not, I mean, you can take this completely out, which I don't really remember ever having to do that. But we will see when we go down there and see if this is coming out or not. I think we can just lower the transmission and that will kind of just snake its way out of there. See, it'll kind of eventually make its way up around the loop-de-loop. So if you're not subscribing to the blown capacitor and you actually like drive a car, I don't know what you're doing with your life, but you guys got to get on it, because I am just giving away secrets of the trade. So in order to get these bell housing bolts, as you can see, just take a whole bunch of extensions, probably just could have did with those two. And what you're going to want to do is tape them together. So then when you need just the one extension, it's very, very hard to get them apart and you start yelling. But then take you, in this case, we need a 15 swivel socket. And I will show you what this is for. This is so... can we see it? Okay. It is very hard to see. You can kind of see it. I'm going to keep this still and I will point an arrow at where the bolt that I'm going for is. That would be the bolt. And see, of course, that little piece of crap is up in there. This stupid garbage stuff. Okay. So right there, that's what this big old long thing is for. Now, what you're going to want to do is put a ratchet on the end of that. And then once you get them broke free, then you can take your 3/8 gun and then go from there. They do actually make really long extensions, which is a 1/2 inch on one side and 3/8 on the other. And what that does is you're gonna lose a lot of your bang and your torque through any type of extension that you have. So you put it on a 1/2 inch gun and then it just works wonders. We've actually got one, two on this side, which I know you can't see anything. I'm really sorry for that. And then there's one up there right up underneath that wire. And you just can't see the other ones. Very, very hard to get to. So that's why I do that and tape them together, because as, hey, what's up, guys? This is Trent, not Richard, back at you. Richard back at you is a good guy. But, oh, Trent taught me that about taping your swivel sockets onto your extension, because they will always knock off. And I just take it a step further and I go ahead and put some tape on each extension when I use more than one. You could get like 50 of these together. And also now would be kind of good time to go back. And you're gonna have a couple on this Dakota. You're gonna have some electronics which come up over here, and there's two plugs over here, very easy to get off. I usually just take them and kind of put them to the side And if you look here, I think I can get you in there. Yep, see, that's the bottom of that rod that goes up to the shifter. So yeah, once we get this thing out, the whole thing will just drop down, and Bob's your auntie. So I'm literally, I think, like 6 bolts away from that point. And yeah, super easy. Onward and upward. Okay, so we've got everything all loose, got all of our tricky bolts up there. I don't think I really mentioned, you got to take the starter off, which is right here. And there's 2 bolts. Now these bolts, there's one here that's a long bolt, and then there's another one right here. And those bolts, you got to use a 1/2-inch drive, and they are in there tight. So be careful of those. But, God, you can see it from here. I noticed I got it all loose and stuff. You see, yeah, transmission's loose. Can't get it out, though. That's because I did not remove the exhaust. I guess that's the first step on this. So hopefully you're watching this video all the way through before you attempt your repair. But I actually just did a short on this because I was like, man, I was all like crying and boo-hooing because these bolts kind of don't look too great. And I did a short and I said, man, you know, this is what you got to do, blah, blah, blah. And then I said, it's going to be a big job removing those because we don't have any oxygen for our tank. So I can't cut anything, can't heat really anything up. But literally, I put my ratchet on there and all 4 of the bolts just broke free like somebody had already been here. So I'm going to take that as a blessing and remove them, get them out of there. And then we're home from here. So yeah, we will be back. Would you guys believe that I actually skipped a step that I didn't tell you? There's 4 Torx bolts on top of there, which is the bottom of the shifter. You're going to want to undo that and then just pop that out. But I think we're pretty close to having us a transmission here. Maybe give her a couple more. Lifts up. Oh yeah, we got us a transmission. I'm really regretting not bringing the... There's our other bolt we were looking for. But yeah, I'm really regretting not bringing the GoPro because my phone just does such a tight shot. You gotta get way back. But yeah, we got that undone up there. Everything else is done. All of the bell housing. So I'm gonna set you down and we're gonna go ahead and lower this. That's a horrible view. It's the best you're gonna get. I think I'm going to end this one here. If you have any questions about removing, yeah, the first video is going to be removal. Second video is going to be installing the clutch and reinstalling the transmission and all that. Like I was going to say, if you have any questions, comments, concerns, bleep them down there. Subscribe for more free auto tips all the time, and I do audio, so it's worth giving us a subscribe. So yeah, that's it for this one. Stay tuned. Probably tomorrow we will be
installing the clutch, doing everything we gotta do, and reinstalling transmission, exhaust, all of that. So thank you so much for watching. We'll see you in the next one.